Frantic moments shared in court. A jury heard a portion of the 911 calls made on the day two young girls were hit by a pickup truck while sledding. One of the calls was made by the grandmother of Shauna Linsenbigler. She died days after the accident. Her friend, Brittany Raymond, was hurt but survived. Both callers were emotional and desperate for help. Channel 4 Action News reporter Ari Height is live with our story. Ari?
Yeah, Mike, the jury tonight wrapped up without reaching a verdict. They will come back tomorrow morning. One piece of evidence they have to consider is, as you said, just a portion of those 911 tapes. So what you're about to hear, even the jury hasn't heard. But I want to warn you, these tapes are very emotional and heartbreaking.
Yes, I'm calling because a little girl here got hit here on Smegley app.
That is how the first 911 call began. It was December 11, 2005. Two young girls had just been hit by a truck when their sled went onto Negley Avenue in Turtle Creek. The driver sped away from the scene. 10-year-old Shauna Linsenbigler was killed. Her friend, 11-year-old Brittany Raymond, was seriously injured. The first call is from Brittany's father. At first, he thinks only Shauna was hit.
Somebody hit my daughter.
But then learns Brittany was hit as well and hurries to the street, remaining on the phone.
My daughter right here. What happened, baby? Brittany, what happened? Oh, baby, a car. Jake, you got to get an ambulance there quick.
The ambulance is coming.
Okay, is she, conscious, sir?
Yeah, she's conscious, but she's bleeding.
Okay, where is she bleeding from?
From her head.
Okay, I want
from
you to...
From her eye.
Once the ambulance is dispatched, the 911 operator focuses on who is responsible. The phone is handed to 14-year-old James Zeitelman, Shauna's cousin. He was on the sled but fell off before it went into the road.
Did you see who was driving it?
No, all I saw was a little big bang, and then I looked down on the street, and all I saw was a truck, and then I saw the kids just rolling out from under the truck.
While that call was going on, Shauna's grandmother, Mary Linsenbigler, had also called 911 from inside the house.
Is she conscious talking to you?
No. Oh, please, hurry.
The call goes on for 90 seconds until Mary hangs up.
Ma'am, is she still outside?
You know what? I'm going to her. I can't.
Ma'am. Ma'am.
This is the man prosecutors say is responsible. Thomas Moore faces numerous charges, including involuntary manslaughter. The last thing the jury did today before going home, they asked the judge if they could hear what you just heard, the entire 911 tape. The judge will pick up that issue tomorrow morning and decide before the jury begins deliberating once again. Live downtown at the county courthouse, Ari Height, Channel 4 Action News.